Listen to what Allah says in Surah Al-Mu'minun. He tells Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَقُلْ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ وَارْحَمْ وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O my Rabb, forgive and have mercy, for you are definitely the most merciful. Subhanallah. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using the same words, رَبِّ اغْفِرْ وَارْحَمْ وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on us. Another aspect of forgiveness, Allah says, Subhanallah, this is a lesson we learn. You need to make dua for the forgiveness of others as well. Ya Allah, forgive all the believers. Ya Allah, forgive my parents. Ya Allah, forgive the parents of the others. Ya Allah, forgive my children. Ya Allah, forgive my brothers and sisters. Ya Allah, forgive my family members. Ya Allah, forgive my wife or my wives. Ya Allah, forgive my offspring and so on. We need to make dua for others. Because if you take a look at Ibrahim alayhi salam, Nuh alayhi salam, both in Surah Ibrahim as well as in Surah Nuh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks of their respective du'as. And both of them made du'as for their parents as well as for the rest of the believers. Listen to what Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam said. رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْحِسَابِ. Oh Allah, forgive me and forgive my parents and forgive all the believers the day you take the accounts. The day of reckoning, the day of judgment. Listen to what Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam said. He says, رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ وَلِمَنْ دَخَلَ بَيْتِيَ مُؤْمِنًا وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ. Oh Allah, forgive me, forgive my parents, and forgive any believing male or female who has entered my house, and forgive all the other believing males and females. Allahu Akbar. This was a dua of the prophets. What does it cost us to make dua for others? Do you know when you make a dua for someone else, the angels say Ameen to that dua. So if you say, Ya Allah, forgive them, the angels are saying, Oh Allah, grant him the same. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really grant us goodness. Sometimes we become so stingy when someone is getting something similar to us, we don't want. Someone has a vehicle and someone offers us a similar vehicle, we say, No, I want a better one, I want a different one. Subhanallah. There is a joke on a lighter note, I think I should share it. People are looking very serious today. They say there was a man who had 3 wishes on condition that his worst enemy was to be given double that which he wished. So whatever he wanted he would have got, but his worst enemy was to get double. I'm showing you stinginess of man, how stingy man is. Even though he is getting what he wants, he doesn't want his enemy to get more. Come on, you said you want 1 billion rands, you get 1 billion. If he gets 2 billion, so what? That's him. So the first thing he asked for, a beautiful house. So he got a beautiful house and his enemy got a double beautiful house, even more beautiful. Subhanallah. He looked and he was gritting his teeth. Wow, it shouldn't have happened. That's how stingy man is. So the second wish, he wished for the most merchandise he could have ever had, a large amount. He got that huge amount, a mountain full. His enemy got 2 mountains full. He's looking and he says, Hey, now I've got everything I want. I got a beautiful home, I got a mountain full of wealth. But my enemy is across the road there. I can't stand that. He says, Okay, my third wish, just scare me half to death. So he was scared half to death and he wanted his enemy to be scared to death itself. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. That is how man is. And this is the difficulty with man. That we are taught that when you pray for someone else, the angels are making a similar prayer for you. And who is better in prayer? Us or the angels? Definitely the angels. So there's a better prayer being made for yourself. So learn to pray for others. Ya Allah, grant them. Ya Allah, this man with a business across the road, give him barakah. The angels are saying, Allah, give that man even more barakah. Subhanallah. Are we ready to do that? That's the sign of a believer. When our iman is weak, we tend to fight. That man, look, send your people, go across the road. Everybody who's going to his shop, divert them here. May Allah protect us. Sustenance is in the hands of Allah. Yes, you are allowed to employ methods to lure the customers, but not dirty cutthroat tactics in order to lure people away from others. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that it's important that we seek forgiveness for others as well. We've heard the verses. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that we should also request others to make dua for us, for forgiveness. Listen to what happened. In Yusuf alayhi salam's story, beautiful story which we read tonight in Taraweeh, the sons, they tell the father,
قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا اسْتَغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا خَاطِئِينَ.
They said, oh our father, seek forgiveness for us. We made a very big mistake. We committed a big sin. Oh our father, seek forgiveness for us. He was a prophet. He sought forgiveness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave them. Subhanallah. So it's important sometimes there's a pious person, a person whom inshallah we feel that they are good or they've engaged in good deeds, your parents and so on, you ask them, make dua for forgiveness. Not just make dua for me. The most important dua, the most important prayer is that for forgiveness. Not for money and for everything else. Forgiveness. If Allah forgives you, the rest will fall in place. So we ask people for forgiveness. We don't ask them in the sense that we don't make the dua to them, but we make the dua to Allah, or we ask them to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is permissible in Islam. In fact, it is a good deed, it is meritorious when you go to someone and seek forgiveness from them, or you ask them to make a dua for you. Even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that to one of his companions, لا تنسانا في دعائك. Don't forget us in your duas. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the understanding, and I am here asking you not to forget me, inshallah, in your du'as. We ask Allah to forgive me, and I ask you also to seek the same for myself and for everybody else, inshallah. So we have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding us again to say that now if you have asked someone for forgiveness, say those who asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to seek forgiveness for them, or the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sought forgiveness for some. Allah says, if they themselves did not repent and are not remorseful of what they did, there's no point in anyone asking for forgiveness for them. And we mentioned these verses a few nights back when we spoke of the hypocrites. Listen to what Allah says in Surah At-Tawbah about the hypocrites.
اِسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ أَوْ لَا تَسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ إِن تَسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ سَبْعِينَ مَرَّةً فَلَن يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ.
Seek forgiveness for them or don't seek forgiveness for them. Even if you seek forgiveness for them 70 times, Allah won't forgive them because they themselves don't want the forgiveness. So that is why we need to cleanse our hearts of hypocrisy. We need to ask for forgiveness. We need to admit our sins firstly. Then those who seek forgiveness on our behalf, inshallah, it will also be accepted because we ourselves have turned first. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to tell us, and this is extremely important, that when we make dua, we don't make dua for hypocrites, number one. Unless we are making dua that Allah guide them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide them, and may He never make us from amongst them. Then we don't make dua for mushrikeen, those who associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are earning the anger of Allah. If they've passed away on that condition, we don't make dua for them. That's the injunction of the Quran.
مَا كَانَ لِلنَّبِيِّ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن يَسْتَغْفِرُوا لِلْمُشْرِكِينَ وَلَوْ كَانُوا أُولِي قُرْبَى.
Allah says it is not for the Prophet or for the believers to seek forgiveness for the mushrikeen, even if they are relatives. However, whilst they are alive, we are allowed to seek dua or to make a dua for them for guidance. Ya Allah, guide them. Ya Allah, we ask you to guide all those who are associating partners with you to the right path, and we ask you to make us from those who will never associate partners with you, who will worship you alone, Ya Allah. Because the very next thing I want to mention is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says there's one thing He won't forgive. One thing He won't forgive. And that is, if a person dies on the condition of shirk, which means he has associated partners with Allah, and he did not seek forgiveness whilst he was alive. If he seeks forgiveness whilst he was alive, he will be forgiven because he falls under the other verse. But if he died in the condition where he was associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a polytheist, and he did not seek forgiveness, Allah says,
إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَٰلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ.
Allah will never forgive someone who died in the condition of associating partners with Allah and did not seek forgiveness, but Allah will forgive besides that whatever He wishes to forgive. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all goodness, and this verse is in Surah An-Nisa.